Start.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel Aditi Wanders, and here I'm wandering again and I've landed myself in Bandipur. So Bandipur, quick summary. Bandipur is around, it'll take you 6 hours from Bangalore to Bandipur. We drove on our own, so this is a good place if you want to spend your weekend or 2 weeks, 2 days or something of that sort here. This video is basically comparing and helping you make a choice if you want to visit Sarai or Windflower, where I am at present. You can see it in the backdrop. I have stayed in both the places, therefore I think I am at a good place to make or help you pick out a place if you are confused about which one do you want to go for. Though obviously, let me make it clear from point one itself that they both are not comparable at all, because Sarai, I think you would have to pay double the price of what you will pay in Windflower. So when I say I'm comparing, I'm not pitting them against one another, because they both are in different category altogether. But you know, I'll be making my judgment according to the price I pay, you know. So basically just rating these two places and help you figure out where you want to come if you come to Bandipur. We'll make it very, very objective so that it's and give both of these properties a point. So here we go. The first would be, say, the location. So in Bandipur, basically there's no stunning view that you get no matter which property you stay at. Windflower is more, gives you this jungle feel. Sarai gives you some mountain view in a very well manicured property. So I would give them both the same rating, which is like 4 on 5. So 4 on 5 for Sarai, 4 on 5 for Windflower. Okay, point number 2, hospitality. The most important thing, right? This is hospitality industry indeed. And Sarai floored me. Literally, their staff is so proactive. They go out of their way. They are so damn polite. They do everything to make you feel so comfortable and welcome. I give them 6 on 5. This is for you. This thumbs up for everyone who is a staff in Sarai, and if you're watching this, Sarai Bandipur. Windflower, well, no negatives that I would be talking about the staff here, because but there was nothing extraordinary. I would say they need to retrain some of their staff, because they could do so much better, I feel, you know. I have stayed in some of Windflower properties, and I would say the staff here is a little bit on the inferior side compared to those. So I would give this a 3.5. So the staff in Sarai 6 on 5, and here 3.5 on 5. Again, now coming to food. Well, here the food you can actually include in your hotel package when you're paying, and it would be cheaper for you. And in Sarai, only the breakfast complimentary. You have to go there and pay for your own lunch and dinner and everything of that sort. And again, just putting this out there, all of my ratings will be as per the price that I'm paying, right? So here, because it's cheap, obviously the menu is restrictive to North and South Indian, and that's okay with me, right? But then again, for vegetarians, it's overly restrictive. For non-vegetarians, maybe they would like it a little more because they have more dishes and things of that sort. Plus, the taste was very meh, average. So I would not give it more than 3.5, maybe 3.75. But okay, let's just keep it 3.5. Sarai, for the price that we are paying, it's not over the top expensive as well, the food there. But you would get all the options, like literally Asian, North Indian, South Indian, Italian, everything of that sort. And yeah, well worth the price. The presentation was on fleek. Everything was really, really good. So I can't point out any faults. So I would just say 4.5, because everything has a scope to be better. And there were a couple of dishes I did not like so much. So 4.5 on 5, okay. Now, coming to what is there left? Okay, the comfort. Okay. Let me just put it out there that you are paying for comfort in Sarai, right? So you expect that kind of comfort. Nothing extraordinary for the amount that you're paying. So that's the amount of comfort you would expect from such a place. So yeah, it's luxurious comfort, and I would give it 4.5 and 5 because there are a couple of pointers that they could actually improve in their rooms. So yeah, but definitely 4.5 and 5, if not 5 and 5. And here I'm being super critical, okay, because we paid a lot for that place. So yeah, now coming to Windflower. Well, like I told you before, I have been to other Windflower properties as well, and this one, not just in the staff wise but overall, like even the comfort wise. Again, I'll be uploading that video where I am giving the room tour. I know it's supposed to have that rustic feeling, right? Even the Sarai was supposed to have a rustic feeling. You can make it in different ways. But this is not that comfortable. The room smells a little bit that monsoon season, the rainy smell, something of that sort. There aren't enough lights. Maybe it's the ambience that they are trying to create, but I did not really dig it so much. The washroom somehow seems, and even the sofas, you know, they are not very well maintained. They are not very comfortable. The bed is okay for the price that we are paying, but overall, you know, the cleanliness wise, the room, and I am a cleanliness freak, so it does bother me a lot. And no matter what, this is a good property, and I expected better from them. So I would just give it 3.5 just based on this, that they are not able to keep their rooms completely clean. And you know, it's not about out and out that it's dirty, but it's the small corners and things that matter, you know. They should get this right. So Windflower, you need to buck up your game, you know. Just clean, keep things clean. Okay, overall now, property wise and in property, I'll include everything from maintenance of the property to how well kept it is. Oh, just the pool. Pool, I'll give both of them equal marks because both are sort of infinity pools. It's just that, yeah, Bandipur has a the Sarai has a bigger pool and everything, but I give them equal points is because we are paying half the price here, right? So keeping that in mind, I would give both of them at the same place. Both are infinity. Sarai has a bigger beautiful pool, but I would give them the same marks, 4.5 each, or 4 each, whatever it is. They both are same on that bit. Amenities wise, both are, let me see, you get the indoor games in both the places. Both are open spaces. Yeah, obviously amenities wise, you have a little more amenities in Sarai, little more area to sit, relax, explore, all of that, because it's a much bigger property. Oh, if you love photos, Sarai hands down wins big time. Big time. Like, you can spend 2 hours there and still you would miss out places where you could take pictures, you know. But it's a property spread over 36 acres, so that's a lot. And compared to that, it's a tiny property. But again, like I said, the money is double that you are paying. So I would say amenities wise, I'll put both at the same place. Yeah, because the amenities is something that you pay for. So yeah, both at the same place. Now coming to overall property, right? For the money that I've paid for this property, the positive about Windflower is that you get all the jungle feels. Yeah. You feel like you are in jungle. They literally ask you to lock yourself after 10:30 PM into the room. Means it's serious. There has been some leopard sighting here or something of that sort as well, near the rooms and all of those things as well. So yeah, you get the jungle feels. A big negative is it's really small. So you know, for a resort to actually give you some privacy, to have separate areas, it's not like that. Everything is just all in one place. It's quite dense, as in, you know, the pool is right next to the room, as you can hear. The rooms are quite next to, literally opposite each other, and the activity area is next to the restaurant, which is just nearby. So everything is in just one small place. That does seem a bit cramped, right? I don't know. Even the Bangalore resort, the Windflower Bangalore resort, has much bigger area than this. So I don't know the thought that went behind this. And literally, they are building new buildings in this very same area. It would just get more cramped with time, I guess. But the money matters, doesn't it? Whatever. So yeah, that is something I would say about the property. So overall, and it's not well maintained, I'll be very honest. Right? I saw only a couple of people trying to maintain it. Even when I put up the review, you'll get to see dirt and stuff everywhere. It's not just the rooms. So maintenance-wise, it's very low on maintenance. And come on, you expect that from this property. No matter, it is a good property, and you expect that kind of maintenance which you don't get here. So that's why I rate it as 3.5 overall property-wise. So why? Well, property-wise, see, location-wise, I cut the points because there was nothing outstanding, but property-wise, it's extremely, extremely well maintained, which again you expect at that price point. So there was nothing extraordinary, but nothing negative that I could point out. Everything was very gorgeous, very beautiful. There were hundreds of places, photo ops and everything. I'll give that property 4.5 because there's nothing literally that I can cut from there. Yeah, just that the cycles that were kept there could have had better maintenance. Again, that doesn't come in property, but because I did not include it anywhere else, I'll put them here. The cycles were quite old and rusted. They could do much, much, much better. So I'll give it 4 on 5 and this 3.5 on 5. But actually, 4 is a bit unfair, so maybe 4.5. Yeah, so between 4, 4.5, okay, something like that. Overall, and yeah, value for money. Now, the biggest point, guys, the biggest point, which one should you choose? Value for money. Windflower is half the price of Serai. Very honest, upfront. Okay, this is value for money. Definitely would not deny it, but a big but. You expect this place to be better maintained. You expect the staff to be well trained. Come on. Come on. Right? I mean, it's not like a homestay that I've come to. I expected way better from Windflower. So for me, value of money, value for money, sorry, is fine. But overall, I'll rate Windflower 3.5 on 5. That's my final rating for Windflower, 3.5 on 5. Pause. And now coming to Savai. See, it's nothing that the staff or anyone can help with because it's Bandipur. You get what in whatever city you are at. So if I'm in Bangalore, obviously I wouldn't get the beach. But again, if you're paying that premium price, I gave it fair and square marks for property, food, whatever, and everything. But for the money I spend, I don't get to see anything extraordinary, nothing at all. So, but the staff was so amazing, the food was good, everything was good. So after doing all the calculations, 4.5 and 5, 4.5, yeah, despite the money that I paid for. Because I'll tell you something, according to me, my recommendation is if you can spend 2 nights here, I would strongly suggest that you scrap that plan out. You go to Sarai, spend 1 night, and that would be a better deal for you. Trust me on that. You would get better food, you would get better service, better hospitality. You can do much better things. You can take so many amazing photos. You can enjoy the amenities, which are almost the same, but then better food. Everything's better. So if you want to, okay, I also get that I can't compare 1 day to 2 days, but then overall, I would say the better suggestion is, or the what I would definitely do is, if I were you and I could afford 2 nights in Windflower, I would rather put all that money and go to Sarai for 1 night. So that's out. You tell me now, which one do you prefer? Have you been to Bandipur? Which property did you visit? And what are your views about it? Do you agree with my views? And if you do, then please write it in the comments down. If you don't, I'm more than happy to discuss it with you. Again, put in the comments down, like, subscribe to my channel, follow my channel, click the notification bell, not follow my channel, click the notification bell so that you get all the alerts when I put up any videos. I am trying to be more regular on YouTube, so please help your girl out, and I'll see you guys soon. Ciao.